answer will not be found in the Google. It will never be found in any book or anyone who's genius or anyone you think so wise. There's one God who will give us everything that we need. He knows every desire. He knows when you get up and when you sleep again. Oh, do you know that He knows how many hairs we have? He was the one who needed us in our mother's womb. And when we were there in the womb, it is such a great miracle. I just learned that our eyes, the way it was formed, it's just wonderful. I am not a scientist, I'm not good at explaining it, but just Google it how it's done, but you know it's wonderful. And let me tell you this song. He was able to create it when his child died. Would you imagine? His child died and all he could think of is worship the Lord. He was able to write this very wonderful song. And he said, whatever happened to me, everything that I have is not mine. It is owned by God. Even that child is not mine. It is owned by my God, and He has the right for everything. And all I will do is worship and worship Him. And then the devil appeared, trying to mock Him. So he took two seats, and he said, Satan, sit down. Watch me worship my God. Undergoing something that is painful or hurtful, or you are fearful, erase all of that, because today our God is going to do something great. He is the God of miracles. Open your heart, receive from the Lord today. Hallelujah. It's the same God yesterday, today, and forever.
It's real.
we have to believe it. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. And everything else that we are looking for will be added. Let's desire that everything that we do is only for Jesus. He died for us years ago. He did not withhold anything. Our God did not withhold His only Son. If you have five children, if I ask for one, I bet you will not give it to me. But our God Almighty has only one, and He didn't hesitate. Sing the song with much conviction, only for Jesus. Only for Jesus. Everything else is changing around us. Even your friend will change. But our God is constant and steadfast. Our God is our firm foundation. And He has given us a kingdom that is unshaken.
You're my future. generation today, O God, that this heart of ours, this very heart that you gave us, will not want anything else but you. Father, we thank you because we have used this heart for so many other purposes before. But we thank you because you are the God that reminds us that this heart shall beat not for any other things, but only for you. That in everything that we feel, that we function upon, it will be according to your alignment and according to your will. That sounds quite impossible to many, Lord. But you are the God that has already completed everything that is impossible and showed us that it is indeed possible, not through our own ability, but through your ability in us. So now, Father, as we step into hearing your voice, understanding your truth, as you reveal the reality of your word to us today, we declare, Father, that our hearts will be aligned to beat like yours, that we may understand what keeps you going, Father. What was your motivation? That is our very desire right now, Father. And Holy Spirit, we know that you are here. We know that you are mighty. We acknowledge that you are the teacher. And we position you in the midst of us today. Use your servant as your footstool. And just submit my entire being to you, Father. Equally as I submit the ones that will be hearing your word. We believe that our hearts are like rich soil, ready to accept everything that you will teach us, that you may be able to plant the seeds of your truth upon our hearts, and that it may bring forth wonderful fruits that will be a blessing to us and a blessing to those people that you love. May you be glorified, Father, Holy Spirit. It is not by might, not by power, but only through your Spirit, O Lord. In Jesus' name, everybody says,
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.